What are some of the, briefly, what are some of the do's and don'ts when it comes to a negotiation?
Ashad, there are a few things in the both sides, do's and don'ts. Let me take in priority order. I suggest my clients, business owners, when they seek my advice, do keep control of the negotiation process. Don't give control back to your negotiation counterpart. How do you do that? That's the question. The way to keep control of the negotiation process is ask questions. The more questions you ask, especially emotional questions, questions to get the feelings and the emotions, questions that gives in-depth answers, not, you know, close-ended questions, but open-ended questions. The more questions you ask, you feel that you have the control of the negotiation process. When you have the control of negotiation process, you have an advantage of that. That is one aspect that that I suggest. Number two, often the people tend to focus more on result or profit rather than the negotiator. My advice is, don't first focus on the result. Imagine we are negotiating to cut the cake. My objective is to get the biggest portion for me. And you also have the same objective. I say, Arshad, this, the bigger part should be mine. Don't even think about it. I need 90% of the cake. But then you also have the same objectives. You said, no, this, you also have the ownership of this cake because I also participate in making it. I also have at least a 50% of the cake. So if, when I negotiate to get the part of the cake, the result, the profit, the revenue, that makes it more difficult. If I focus first on the negotiating counterpart, Arshad, you know that. You have no right to ask for half of the cake. It was my material, my effort, my recipe. I have 90%. Now, why are you fighting like mad to get to 50%? That means this is a negotiator focusing on the negotiating counterpart. Then you could say this, well, this is not for me. I usually pass through this Rajagiri every day and there's an orphanage. It's amazing, those little boys and the girls. Sometimes I take biscuits, toffees and give them, and how, when they enjoy, it's very rewarding, man. I know I will not have the bigger part, but if I can have at least half of it this evening when I go to, in that direction, I can cut it for that 40 pieces and give it to them. I say, wow, Arshad, why didn't you tell me? I also love to support those kids, destitutes, kids in orphanage. Why half? Take my half as well. When you go, let me know. I am also come behind you. Let's go to this evening. That, imagine I was fighting to get 90% of the cake. You are fighting to get 50% of the cake. Now I am willing to give up entire things because I know what your motive is. We have a common or shared interest. Helping poor kids. That comes only if you or I focus on the other person and not the result. So long as we focused on the size of the cake, profitability, revenue, terms and conditions, all those, the other aspect, hard aspect, it will not be easy. The moment you focus on the other person, I'm not saying the profitability is not important. Profitability is important. What I'm trying to say is the shift of the focus. The moment you shift the focus on your negotiating counterpart, it's easy to negotiate. And have you realized, Arshad, we have improve the value of the cake. It's no longer cake, it's a rewarding exercise, rewarding experience for you and for me. You cannot assign the value to that. It has expanded exponentially. This is where we say focusing on the negotiator first will be helpful. And there are a few things that I request my clients to avoid. Number one is, don't use threat or manipulation. Very short term. Sometimes threatening is the shortest way, easiest way to get the negotiation outcome. But in long run, it's very damaging. No, after a while, people will realize nobody wants to negotiate, do business with you. So avoid threatening or manipulation because it's a very short term. The other one, I don't know, this is my personal opinion. I request in negotiation not to give anything free. It has to be something for something, nothing for nothing. I said, the moment you give free something this time, next time, they included it in the basic package. You gave it last time? I don't want to talk. It is in the package. Now give me something more. What I suggest is, if you have to give up something, take something in return. Something for something, nothing for nothing. These are the few things that I advise a good negotiator to do's and don'ts or avoid.